I'm Brittany Ryan Statler.
And I'm Samantha Mackey.
And for our project, we did Don't Go With The Flow. For our project, the purpose we did it was because we watched the news a lot, and we saw that all the major storms were happening in the Northeast, and then the earthquake in Japan, and we wanted to see if we could have a better idea if sandbags did work the best, or if there was another material that might have been better. So we decided to use 5 different types of medias, and it was topsoil, potting soil, pea gravel, kitty litter, and sand, just so we could get an accurate reading on sand to make sure if it was like the same as they say it was. So we did it because
we came up with 2 hypotheses. One was that kitty litter would do the best, and we thought this because kitty litter absorbs more and it expands when it's wet. It's designed to absorb different fluids. And we decided that pea gravel was going to do the worst because it contains many voids when in a bag, and we thought water would go right through it.
Well, when we first started out, we had a brainstorm, and we had a little bit of time during science class because Miss Whitaker, she let us have a whole period just to think of what we were going to do. And at first, we thought we were going to do something on earthquakes because we knew we wanted to do something in the environment, but we didn't know what yet. So we thought we were going to do earthquakes at first, but we noticed that there were too many variables that we couldn't control. So we decided to do floods instead. And after we brainstormed and got everything ready and know what we wanted to do, we got the burlap bags and cut them into 15 centimeters by 30 centimeter pieces, and then we sewed them. And we left a little hole at the top of the burlap bag so we could funnel the material that we needed into it. And then after we did that, we were testing, and we had to make sure that because of our container, we had cut a hole in it so we could use the flood simulator and so the water could come out. And we left 2 lips on each side so we could like tuck in the burlap bag so there wasn't a hole so the water could just come out. And when we did that, we stacked them 2 across and about 3 high. And we tried to at all times fill it about the same like each time. But sometimes the bags might have been smaller because they may have been more compact or taller. So we just poured the water in about even with the top of the bag so it didn't go over the bags. After we did that, we each time it went down maybe 2 or 3 centimeters, we took what time it was and recorded it. And when we had all of it done, we recorded it and composed the data, and this is our results.
Okay, so potting soil turned out to be the best one, which was a huge surprise for us because we didn't expect that. We came up with a couple observations for all of these. So for potting soil, we have when the water was first put in, the burlap bags floated, but then as it got wet, they became more compacted. So as soon as we put the water in, the bags began to float because the potting soil was so light. So we had to let it kind of get wet before it totally compacted and held back the water as well as it did. For topsoil, the water came out a lot at first, and then it gradually slowed down. We were kind of surprised with the results and how it turned out. We thought it was going to hold back more, but it turned out to let a little bit of water go through, but it was still a pretty good material to use. For pea gravel, as the bags got wet, the water poured out quicker because there was nothing to absorb it. So because it contained many voids and it was all solid and it didn't really hold much, it let water go through just as we had predicted. Water first came out fast, and it got wet as it slowed to a steady rate with kitty litter. So it did absorb a lot, but it didn't do as well as we thought it was, which was a big surprise because we thought kitty litter was going to do really well because it absorbs and it expands. And for sand, it was very steady throughout the whole testing, and it did not very much. So it basically was really consistent the whole time, and it never really changed. So we were kind of surprised with that. We thought it was going to hold back more, but it turned out not to. We made a chart showing how the media effectiveness comparison dropped over time, and potting soil was the best, and pea gravel did the worst. We came up with some cost comparisons too, because even though potting soil can be the best one, that still doesn't mean that it's going to be the most cheap and easy to use. So we came up with a chart over here, and it says that sand for the price per feet cubed was $4.85, for potting soil $7.41, for kitty litter $7.30, for topsoil $1.27, and for pea gravel $6.76.
So the kitty litter, it was pretty expensive, and also the potting soil was expensive. It worked very well, and it was light, but if they had to buy it, it would be pretty expensive to buy because it was the most expensive on our list. But we drew the conclusion in our hypotheses. One of them was right because the pea gravel didn't hold as much as it was because of those voids that were in the bags. And the kitty litter, it was about the third best. It was after sand. And because potting soil did the best because it absorbed, because it's usually when you have potting soil and you plant plants in it, when you water it, it wants to hold as much water so you don't have to keep watering it like every day. And we also, when we were doing our project, we contacted a person from the Army Corps of Engineering, and we asked them a couple questions about like if they thought flood, why they use sand so much, and if cost does anything, if weight does anything, and he gave us some interesting answers. He said that the sandbags are reused from like over in Iraq or Iran where the wars are going on. Like they use it to like protect themselves from bombs and stuff. They said that they reuse them and they bring it back over from the war when they're done with them. So we thought that was pretty interesting because it was recycled material from a war. And if we were to do it in the future, which we probably will, we said because the potting soil, it did really good, but it floated at first. So we thought if we mix sand with it or put sandbags on top of it somehow, that it wouldn't float and it would still have the same like compatibility that would stop it from flooding.